On behalf of the Spiritwood Energy Park Association, otherwise known as SEPA, welcome to the Golden Spike Ceremony. I can't express how grateful I am to have all of you here with us today. Especially thankful to a few amazing organizations and people. There you are. Thank you to Stuart Milakovich. I probably killed that, didn't I?
You're close.
North Dakota Department of Transportation, there you are. Thank you very much for your help with the project. Bill Davis, Dennis Rodine, and Josh Kramer with USDA Rural Development. Joanne Rodenbiker with Northern Plains Electric. And Darren Fink. Is Darren here? To tell you the truth, I think we met Darren over there, going that direction. He was in a white pickup, so keep an eye out for him. Darren Fink with First Community Credit Union. Is Carrie Ness here? I can't seem to see anybody. Okay, I'll save that for a minute. A heartfelt thank you to Rich Garman, the SEPA Engineer of the Year, for all of his hard work and dedication to the project. And Randy Aiden, coming, or here, DMVW, I do see, I can't think of his name now, Jeff Woods, and the rest of the crew coming. And I want to say just a few words about the reason we're all here today. Spiritwood Energy Park Association is a partnership between Great River Energy and Jamestown Sussman Development Corporation. SEPA is a development park dedicated to area economic growth and diversification. The business concept is to leverage the development of a more robust energy and transportation infrastructure than any single business might be able to afford on its own, and to share the resulting benefits to attract new businesses under a landlord-tenant relationship to Spiritwood Energy Park. The SEPA Association is the landlord, and we will own and operate the land and improvements, and the individuals will pay their pro rata share, which will almost certainly be at a lower operating expense than if they each duplicated all of the capital infrastructure on their individual sites. The first tenant is the Dakota Spirit Ag Energy Project. It's a 65 million gallon per year corn biofuels project that will produce ethanol, corn oil, and distiller's grain. And they are already buying corn. I believe they're taking it, it's being delivered to Wimbledon. And they will be up and operational second quarter of 2015, and we're very happy to hear about that. The Spiritwood Energy Association presents a unique opportunity to provide resources from those two organizations, the Great River Energy and the Jamestown Sussman Development Corporation, for the significant greater good of the community and of local businesses. Our work here at SEPA is far from over, but what we've accomplished together has successfully laid the foundation for future opportunities for Sussman County. Let's roll up our sleeves and continue this journey to fill the park with more dedication than ever. And hopefully, Mr. John Simmons here will be breaking ground on his E-Nugget project within the very near future. Thank you all very much, and I'm happy to share the podium today with Katie Anderson. Katie?
Well, good morning, everyone. Of course, we're here today for this Golden Spike Ceremony. So I didn't know if everyone really had the history of where Golden Spike Ceremony started. And so I thought I'd give you just a brief history on this. So the first Golden Spike Ceremony started on May 10th, 1869, when Leland Stanford drove the final spike in the first transcontinental railroad connecting the Central Pacific and the Union Pacific Railroads. When this first Golden Spike Ceremony was celebrated in 1869, it commemorated the joining of the East and the West, and it created the interstate commerce system that has truly united the United States. So you fast forward 150 years to this day, October 30th, 2014, and we're celebrating the connection of the Spiritwood Energy Park right here in Sussman County, just 10 miles east of Jamestown, to the same interstate commerce network, that railroad. The ability to produce our goods and send them to market is the backbone of our free enterprise economy, and it really is exciting to celebrate this rail loop connection that will not only support Dakota Spirit Ag Energy as the first tenant in the Spiritwood Energy Park, but all the future tenants to the Spiritwood Energy Park and create this tangible economic growth for our entire region. The city of Jamestown was founded in 1872 after the Northern Pacific Railroad set up camp here where the railroad was going to cross the James River. And the railroad opened their repair yard here, and the railroad became the backbone of the Jamestown economy. So it's no surprise that today, Jamestown is still investing in railroad infrastructure to help grow our local economy. And so I want to say thank you to the taxpayers of Jamestown and of Stetson County for creating the Spiritwood Energy Park and the access to the industrial road network, utility connections, and this full rail loop that will accommodate our additional industrial growth and development, which is now shovel ready. Congratulations to all those who worked so hard to make this a reality, and Spiritwood Energy Park is open for business. And now I'd like to introduce Stetson County Chairman, Commission Chairman Mark Colsey.
Thank you, Katie, and welcome everyone to a very exciting time in our community as we add another major phase to our economic development projects out here at Spiritwood. Truly, this is this park and the future development that we've got going on here is probably, is without doubt, the purest form of economic development that one can find. Creating new wealth, in my opinion, and a lot of others as well, is either you mine it, you farm it, or you manufacture it. We've got it all going on right here. The plants behind us, or behind me and facing you, we're mining coal and we're manufacturing electricity out of it and serving customers around this area to some degree and also in Minnesota. We're manufacturing corn and turning it into ethanol, which we're burning in our cars and our equipment and make combustible engines. And we've got a barley plant here that we're growing barley and turning it into malt, which is a major component in the beer industry. So without question, this is creating new wealth from the ground. It's a tremendous opportunity here for us in Stetson County. We've been blessed with having tremendous partnerships with the private industry, and it's just one, I don't know where you'd find another example like this, where you've got government, local government, state government, federal government, and private industry to create such tremendous opportunities for farmers, for consumers, and for the workforce in our area. So with that, thanks, and look forward to bigger and better things coming. With that, Connie.
Thank you very much, and I see we've been joined by a few other individuals, and one that I would especially like to thank for coming, Carrie Newman-Ness, for coming and bringing to mind that had it not been for Harold Newman, we most likely would not be standing here. It was a dream of his to have this partnership, have this type operation here. So thank you very much for Harold. And then I would be remiss if I didn't introduce the board of directors for SEPA, Al Christensen, Gary Reif, Chris Rathjen, and Greg Riddlebush. And now we're going to proceed with the golden spike ceremony.
There we go.
Yep.
Now, Mark, you get to finish it.
All right, Mark, just go ahead and finish that off for us.
That thing, Mark.
Okay, put it all the way in.
One drive, closing.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Sure.
I'm going to give you a first picture here.
Could do it by itself.